Thank
you. For the toy industry, success is all about Christmas. That accounts for more than a third of all annual sales. Next into the den are David Harvey and Ben Lewis with a tabletop game. They're not looking for a gift from Santa, but they would like an investment.
Would one of you like to give us a honk on the starting horn? Thank you, Peter.
Starting horn?
Just give it a good squeeze at my command. Hello. My name's Dave Harvey, and this is Ben Lewis.
Hello.
And we produce Pucket, an infectiously fun, frantic wooden game. But before we tell you any more, we'd like to give you a quick demonstration. So if you want to come and have a closer look whilst we're playing.
Thank you.
Okay, and horn, please. Yeah. Ooh, okay.
So as quick as I'm trying to fire them through, he's got to fire them back. And it's then a mad rush.
Ah, he's got me. Oh,
got me.
There you go.
You've played this before.
Mm, I have
good.
Played a few times.
Right.
I have
to. Right.
Right.
Come on. One finger on the elastic. And then just place the puck in front of the elastic, and so you're kind of catapulting it through.
Ready?
Right,
flex
on.
Oh, Theo!
Come back!
The faster you can do it, the harder it is for him to get them back.
Oh!
If they're in your way, you can move them out.
You can move them.
You just can't push them through.
Well played. I don't like it.
So we're here to offer you 10% of our business in exchange for £50,000.
We've been producing Pucket games via a fair trade supplier for just over 3 years, and every Christmas to date we've sold out.
This year we're on target to sell 10 to 13,000 games. It works well across the ages and is made to last. As a result, we're not only selling into the kiddies' toy market, but also the adult gift market, with stockists including Selfridges, the Conran shop, and independent design shops around the UK. We'd be happy to take your questions.
Trying to encourage a bit of traditional Christmas gameplay in the den are South Londoners Ben Lewis and Dave Harvey. Having designed a new pastime for the parlour, they're hoping £50,000 can help market it to the great British public. Duncan Bannatyne is first to scrutinise the opportunity on offer.
Who invented this game?
It's actually an old French game, but it's not very well known. I was a student in France, and that's where I first saw it played.
Right, so you have no IP rights to it, you have no...
We've trademarked the name Pucket. In French, it's known as table à l'élastique.
OK. Now, what does it cost you to make?
Our landed cost is £15.75.
Right, what do you sell it for?
The consumer buys it for around 50.
This is a piece of wood with two elastic bands?
Yeah.
And you're selling it for 50 quid?
That's correct, yeah.
You must be really good salespeople. So, give me the historic numbers to start with.
Sure. 3 years ago, we turned over about £6,000. Net profit was about 70.
£70?
Yes, £70. That was just the first Christmas.
OK.
Second year was £29,000.
What happened from 2011 to now?
We turned over £113,000.
What was your net profit?
A net profit, £8,000. I should point out, it should have been more like 21, but some last-minute delays meant we had to air freight, which actually cost us around £13,000. If we sell all 13,000 games this year, profits can increase to up to £60,000.
The poised duo have relaxed quickly into den questioning, but something seems to be bothering Peter Jones.
I have an issue with the actual game itself.
Yeah.
Okay. What's your issue?
I could see me doing it once, and it was exciting when I first sat there, because I thought, well, I want to know how it's played.
Yeah.
But I got bored very, very quickly. It's not that exciting.
When we first started Pucket, I actually made a Pucket game for my brother for Christmas. We had it in the family. We took it on holiday, and we were literally crying with laughter. I myself broke down in tears because we had such amazing fun with this thing.
I should point out, in terms of people, you know, what you say, do people actually enjoy it? A large part of how we generate some sales is going to festivals. You know, these aren't people we know, they're not... And we open at 10, we'll have a tent with maybe a dozen games out, we'll close at midnight, and people will play all day. They've never come across it before.
Really? And yeah. They've all said they've enjoyed it?
Yeah, they've come back throughout the day.
Okay, thank you.
Guys, Pucket.
Pucket.
I'm going to leave it to everyone's imagination how you arrived at the name.
Can we tell you?
Are you going to spoil it?
No. It's because they're pucks and you puck it through the hole.
It's a puck.
And that really is how we came up with the name.
Really?
Yeah.
I believe you.
Thank you.
You told us kindly that you landed this product at £15.75.
Yeah.
What you didn't say is what you sold it for wholesale.
£21.
And what you didn't say is where you have these made.
We have them made in India by a fair trade group. Yeah, in the north of India.
What's the lead time?
It's probably up to a 3-month lead time from buying the wood, seasoning it, making the games and shipping it.
So from order?
Yeah.
Okay.
Part of why we have it handmade and made so well is because it's not just a kind of one-week throwaway present, and we want it to last.
Demonstrating market appeal and strategic thinking, Ben and Dave continue to impress the Dragons. Will Deborah Meaden have any cause for concern?
Can I actually quite, by the way, I quite like it.
Good. Thank you very much.
For a game product, it's high-end product, and I also think its packaging is well targeted at the market that you have identified. Can I just ask about the seasonality? How much of your trade is done at Christmas?
It seems to be about 70% in the final quarter.
When have you got to have your stock in country for you to fulfil those Christmas orders?
We have them all in by the end of September.
So what does that do to your cash flow?
Well, that's a big reason
why we're here. We're asking for money for stock.
Because part of the fair trade... That's
you really probably don't need to explain to any dragon, because it's glaringly obvious to me that you have an issue with... Obviously, you're bound to have an issue with cash flow when so many of your sales happen at Christmas. Can I ask you a question, then? Why do you make in... I understand the fair trade bit, and I applaud you on the fair trade bit, but why are you making in India?
We wanted it to be handmade and beautiful, and so the only way to do that at a cost that isn't prohibitive is to go somewhere where the cost of labour is cheap.
Have you looked at having it made in the UK? It's becoming an awful lot more competitive.
Our prototypes for the future games we're working on, we haven't obviously mentioned those yet, but we're having them made in the UK and prototyped in the UK, and our first production run will be in the UK.
There's a calmness in the den as the smooth-talking duo seem to be addressing all the dragon's concerns, but they've yet to receive an offer. Duncan Bannatyne looks ready to have his say.
This game reminds me, in a way, of a game that I have in my house, I play with the kids, called air hockey.
Yeah, air hockey for traditionalists.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And we play that, and it's much more exciting. And, you know, thinking about paying £50 for that.
We've sold out every Christmas, and I mean, 3,000 people aren't wrong. Clearly, we haven't gone beyond that, because we didn't have the games.
You're very, very articulate and good salesman, Ben. And you, David. Just seems... far, far, far too expensive. So for that reason, I've got to say I'm sorry, but I'm out.
Thank you
very much.
Guys, shall I tell you where I am?
Yes, please.
I can't think of anything more boring than sitting down at night playing that game.
Could we persuade you to have a go?
No, you couldn't. I just didn't like it. It bored me. And I suspect I'm not the only person that will find this boring either. Mm.
That's surprising. That hasn't been our experience, but if that's yours...
Unfortunately, I won't be investing in you today, so I've got to say, I'm out.
The friend's bid for £50,000 takes a turn in the wrong direction. But not all is lost. Three dragons remain. Has Peter Jones seen any money-making potential?
Looking at this as a business, I actually think that what you should have done with that game is made that game completely multi-use.
Right.
I think you should have designed it in such a way where you could insert that elastic band. You can play backgammon on it. You could play chess on it. Mm. But I just think that just having one game, you've limited its market, and I think it's limited in terms of its value.
What a great idea, Peter. Now I know why you're so rich. I've just learned something. Fantastic. Great. No, I'm being serious.
So I think that's what I would have done with this. But I think that you will clearly sell enough to have a living for yourselves, and for that, it's great. I'm not going to invest in you today. I'm out.
Guys, I don't agree with Peter on that. I think that if you do make it a multi-purpose compendium, you'll just be trying to compete with every other multi-purpose compendium you've got. I think the only thing you've got is that you're a new game, that it looks different, it looks lovely. I like it. The trouble is, your valuation would mean there would have to be a much bigger market than I believe there is for me to get the type of return on my investment that I would want. So I won't be investing, guys.
Thank you.
I'm out.
And that just leaves me. And I never found this as boring as the other dragons have said. And I like competitive games. I like games where there's movement as opposed to just sitting there watching them. And I've been sitting here trying to work out what it is that I can do to actually help you make this happen. So it just leaves me to ask you what your other products are.
Yeah, there are two other games that I guess have some similarities in the look. One of them is an old French-Canadian game. And the other one is my own invention. That's another dexterity game where you don't take it in turns. Games where you don't take it in turns tend to be more exciting.
At the moment, you're saying £50,000 is purely required for stock.
Yes.
Well, that's stock in finance that you need.
Yeah.
So did you go to your bank?
Yeah. We did. In fact, you know, we're still talking to our bank, but it looks a little bit touch and go.
Guys, I can't see that it's going to be massive for me. It's certainly not. And if I gave you 50,000 for equity, I would have to take over 50% of the business. It doesn't make sense.
Yeah.
You need a loan.
Okay.
And that's what it sounds like. It's not investable at the moment. So I'm afraid I'm out.
Thank you, Theo.
It was a close call, but ultimately a disappointing end for Ben and Dave. They leave with nothing.
I was wondering whether I'd find a way of just lending them the £50,000 and let them buy the shares back.
The Den isn't a charity thing.
No, exactly.
We're here to make money.
That's right.
Events like Melanie's are big business at Christmas, as the hospitality industry cashes in on our collective festive cheer. But that's nothing compared to our ability to shop. Last December, we spent £42 billion on retail alone.
Some retailers make all of their money in that 4 to 6 weeks running after Christmas. And the rest of the year, they just lose money. Preparation for Christmas starts the previous Christmas. Always does. Once you bought your stock, you bought it. You'll either oversell and run out of stock before Christmas, or you'll undersell. That's so stressful.
The last entrepreneurs to enter the Den this year certainly know that pressure. Ben and Dave make 70% of their turnover at Christmas, and this year they've set their targets high.
So we're at the Country Living Christmas Fair. The aim today is to sell 50 games minimum, or as many games as possible.
Yeah, all empty down there, isn't it? Why are they all up here?
We had about 3,000 games that we sold last year, and this year the target is 10,000. We borrowed so much money to get this stock in,
is a disaster if we don't sell it.
Hello, ma'am. Have you seen Pucket before? Oh, wonderful.
Business is slow. But having failed to get investment in the Den, what impact has that made on their future plans?
Unfortunately, the dragon said no, but amazingly, somebody said yes. We actually knew him already, so we said, look, can we practice our pitch on you? And he was like, oh, I think, you know, guys, I need to think about this. Afterwards, you know, he signed up and we got his investment for the same terms and the same amount of money. So it's great.
Right, Ben, I think it's about time we had our
inaugural game. Okay, let's go.
The sales technique is we play, we make a noise, Ben sees potential customers slowing down, looking interested, and we engineer a quick finish to the game so that we can then say, come and see how it works.
Generally, I just win anyway. I don't really have to engineer it, but there you go.
All right.
Have you seen the game before, madam?
Pull the elastic back. Just the elastic. There you go.
There you go. Thank you very much.
Thanks, guys.
Cheers.
All right. Come on. Come on, Ben.
It's these direct sales where we actually make a decent profit. So 70% of our turnover this time of year, half of that would be through Christmas fairs.
Enjoy the game. Time for you to win now, isn't it?
I had a flurry of sales just recently.
Get your pin.
I think I'm on my 10th or 11th.
Awesome. Thank you.
We'd like to see how the game works, madam.
In some ways, it's a bizarre experience being in the Den because it's possibly the most important business meeting of your life.
The challenge of pitching to five people who've run, you know, well-established businesses for a long time. Yeah, the challenge of justifying your numbers, justifying your business. And actually, I enjoyed it.
Yeah.
That was a quick win. Well played.
Coming to the end of the fair, we're just slightly shy of 50, but, you know, we're happy enough with that. And that works out at about £800 profit. If we get another day like that, we will have paid our stall costs. From then on, we're making money for ourselves.
The dragons thought the market was too small. It might not explode and be the next Apple, but we're not necessarily aiming for that. I guess we're determined to see the business succeed, and it's getting there.
That's it for our special Christmas edition of Dragon's Den. We hope you've enjoyed watching and that you have a very Merry Christmas. Good night.